Welcome to another RealVolve training video. My name is Mark Stepp. I'm the Chief Innovation Officer here and want to show you a brand new feature that we've got for printing to a PDF file. Now, I know a lot of people send emails every day, and there's occasions, though, that you want to actually send a printed document. The email button that we've always had is up here in the upper right corner. You can click on that to send emails. Well, now, right below that, you have this Generate PDF option. And the Generate PDF option allows you to do just that. We can take any template that we've got in the system. If I click on the Generate PDF, you can take and select from a list of templates that you already have in the list. I'm just going to choose Open House, thank you. In which case, we do have merge fields available. You can come in here, make whatever editorial changes that you need to. And if you want to, you know, add an address or some highlights, whatever you want to do, make the change. Once you've made that change, you can click on the Show Preview option, in which case it will take just a few seconds to show you a quick preview of that document, whatever changes you've made. You can close that. And then if you want to actually print it, choose the Create PDF. Now, if you've made any changes to the document and you want to retain those changes, you can choose the Create PDF and Save as Template. You can either update the existing template or create a new template, either one. I'm just going to cancel that. I'm just going to click on the regular Create PDF. You'll see down here at the bottom, it goes ahead and shows you a little pop-up. This pop-up will process for just a few seconds and then give you the ability to click on the download, which will open up that document and show it. If that little pop-up goes away, you have a couple options. Number one, in the radar tab, you may need to refresh it. Just click your radar tab. You'll see that there is a link to that PDF file that was just printed. So you can click on that and pull it up there. Or if it's been a while and you still need access to it, under the Files tab, it goes ahead and puts a copy of that document in there as well and tags it as being a letter. If you click on the little download folder, it will pull it up and you can view it just like any other PDF file. So that's there for an individual contact. You can do similar types of things. If you click on the View All chevrons over here on the left-hand side and select multiple people from the database. Say I want to come in here and I want to select, you could go in, filter a bunch of names if you wanted to and just select them all. Or if you just wanted to select individual names, you can come in here, select however many names that you want. And once again, we have our little PDF file. Click on the PDF. Choose whatever templates that we want. I'm going to choose that same EM open house. Thank you. In the bottom left-hand corner, we do have the ability to save this file. Whenever it's printed, it'll create a PDF file for the individual person. So you can save it to their Files tab. And also, if you're selecting multiple people, maybe you've accidentally selected both the husband and the wife, you can have this option checked here and it will combine them. If they're a husband and wife, it'll only print one letter. In those cases, you do want to make sure that you are printing using, instead of the first name field, maybe the greeting field, because the greeting field would have both husband and wife's name in there. So it would be Hello, John and Mary. Now, what happens then is if you're doing this, at the top, it shows you how many contacts are in the list to be printed. We can still do the show preview like we did earlier. It'll just show the first one. If I go ahead and choose the Create PDF, it goes ahead, closes that screen, and it starts to generate the PDF file. This can take a few minutes if it's a large list, a large file of names, so just be cautious there. Once it's done, you can click on the Download PDF. Now, what we do is every letter is placed on its own page. So if it's a single page letter for three people, you're going to have three pages. If there's multiple pages, obviously it'll go and do that as well. But what this gives you is the ability to have one print feature. You can print all three letters at one time. But what's really cool is that whenever those are printed, if I go to Alfred or I go to Annie here, it creates that individual copy for that individual contact. So this, I was on Ann's record, I can look at it and it's just a single copy of hers. So you get the option to print all of them from that download feature, but each individual person keeps an individual copy of that letter as well. Now, if you missed that little download feature, if it goes away, you can always go in under the settings area. We've got a new section here called printed documents, in which case I can come here, I can click on the download, and it will show me the multiple page document, in this case, all in one spot, and again, print them. Now, I do have the ability, if I wanted to, come in here and say, well, I only want to print 2 through 3, or you know, whatever. It has that ability. So nice features there in case the printer jams or something like that, to go back and reprint some of them. But that's some of the really cool features that we've added recently. If you've got any questions, visit our help site or contact our support at realbob.com. Have a great day.